What is poppin', you guys? Welcome back to another video, and today is Friday, February 28th, 2020. I am in Cincinnati. I would show you, but the curtains are down. I'll probably get some B-roll on the way to the Cincinnati Fishing Expo, where I am going to be spending my weekend. Today we're going to be rolling with a guest you guys have not met yet, so make sure you stay tuned for that. It's going to be a fun day. It's going to be a long day. Enjoy. I'm sitting here in the lobby. We have about 10 minutes till this thing opens. I'm chilling here. We got Brendan. This is who I was playing pool with.
Hey guys.
He's gonna be helping us. So we're gonna try and teach him the ropes here a little bit. Get him to nail down the spiel. But I think it's gonna be a good day. We got things all over the place. We got, you know, a whole nother room that's different from us, hallways full of vendors, stuff like that. But it's gonna be a good day, regardless. Without further ado, let's go make some money. All right, so people are coming in 1 minute, and once they get back to our booth, we're kind of far back a little bit. We're a little bit closer towards the loading dock, which is in the very back. It's going to be pretty insane for about 2 to 4 hours or so, nonstop. So, updates will be pretty minimal, I'd say. But, you know, we're making money. So, I'll try and get in probably 2 companies today for you guys to learn about, talk to them, stuff like that. Stay tuned. Brendan, you got any comments?
Let's make some money.
Let's make some money. Alright. Well, the initial rush started to slow down. It's about 1:30. It's been about an hour and a half. Sitting here in the booth on the official Sasquatch Chicks toilet. How would you say it's gone so far?
Pretty good.
Pretty good.
Not too bad. Got 3 sales.
Definitely not as insane or as busy as Columbus. It's definitely a lot smaller. Starting to figure things out a little bit. Tomorrow is definitely going to be the majority of the crowd. Saturday is always the crazy,
crazy day.
But we're going to keep on doing. Probably going to go snag a lunch break here in about a half hour. So that'll be nice. But oh, it's going to be a long weekend, especially when I'm just tired. Pray for me, y'all. And on this episode of Lunch Breaks with Brendan, we have soft pretzel.
Great.
Try it. How is it? How's it taste? I got an Angus burger. I got chips with it that are probably empty. And the burger, yeah. How's it taste? Very good soft pretzel. Let's try the burger here. Whoa, that's very crooked. There we go. Tomatoes falling out. I did not get a piece of meat on that bite. It's not the best, it's not the worst. Well, we're gonna finish up our lunch break here and get back to work before Brendan has to leave us for lacrosse practice. He might be joining us tomorrow and Sunday. Still to be determined. You ready for the second half of the day?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yep.
Let's roll. All right, guys, we're here in the Lewis and Wright Bass Fishing Tech booth. Look how big this booth is. It goes from that end all the way, way over my shoulder. But I'm gonna turn away from the camera. I'm gonna let this man do what he does best, talk about his baits.
Hi, my name's Jim Wright. I'm Lewis and Wright Bass Fishing. Today I have a ton of different baits. I sell 100 baits, 300 colors, $2 a bag. One of my favorite baits, the rib swim bait, right here. Make them super soft, durable, and they go really good on.
All right, my mom called me, so we're just gonna continue where we picked up or left off.
We're talking about the swim baits that I have, and I have the rib swim baits. These are 3.8 inches, but I do have 3 inch, I have 4 inch, 5 inch, and coming soon is the 7 inch. I have what I call the minnow type swim baits, which are great for trailers as well, and a bladed jig, chatterbait. I do sell a crappie stuff here.
And, so, this has been some of your best sellers today.
Oh, yeah.
Look how big these swim baits are. These are size 11 shoes. That thing is right there with them. So, what was your idea behind making such a big swim bait?
Well, the first thing is I had a lot of musky guys that were very interested in swim baits, and I said, well, you know, I can get a mold for this 10 inch, and ended up being a lot of the southern guys call them the stripers, rockfish. That's what started out. And also, putting them at the table like this, almost everybody walks by, wow, look at these, and they'll grab, pick them up and feel them, and then they'll start looking at everything else. You know, these are $5. I know people that pay $20 for these things.
So what else do you have at this?
Okay, I have like 100 different baits. I have beavers in two sizes, brush hogs, I call them timber hogs, fluke type baits, jerky shad, sticks, 3, 4, 5, 6. I even have the big 10 inch. These are 10 inch. I have the 7 inch. I have the drop shot worms, 3-inch drop shot worms, 4-inch drop shot worms, and 6-inch trick type worms, mischievous worms, what I call them. And I have those in the full round magnum type and also the flat belly finesse type. I have 12 different types of crawls, ranging from the small dinky crawls to 3 3/4 inches, probably the biggest seller.
So, yeah.
Those are the crawl trailers. Those are trailers.
Tiny little chunks.
Here's some of the crawls that I have. I call these the real crawls. I can make them 2-ton. These are what I call the criss crawls. They have a super thin claw. They're real thin. Yeah, you may go through a little more claws on these, but I think with the action, it's worth it. And if you don't, I also have a 3-inch, what I call a junior crawl, and that has a lot thicker, more subtle action, makes a good trailer. These are the dink crawls I was talking about here.
Real tiny,
small,
tiny,
yeah.
So here's some of the beaver baits.
Yeah, those are 3.5 inch. You don't see too many of those. A lot of guys say they may have trouble with hooks. Just use a 2-aught extra wide. If you're careful, you can get a 3-aught in there too. Just gotta, it really covers the end here. So you gotta make sure you get that the right size hook. It does matter the 3-aught, 2-aught for sure.
Here's something pretty wild.
That's I call those the boom boom bugs. I named those after my brother-in-law. He's a big golfer. He nicknamed himself Boom Boom. So I thought, well, I'll make those. Ned rig. Put a head on those.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Stand up just like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah. And then I had Texas rig for smallmouth, but and throw those on the back of a trailer, back of a jig. They're going to be awesome as well.
We got boxes on boxes of stuff. Whole row of packages. Thank you so much for talking.
Thank you.
So how can we get these baits if we wanted them?
Well, contact me. It's Lewis and Wright Bass Fishing. If you just do a Google search, I'm all over. But the website is lewisandwrightbassfishing.com. Email is just sales@lewisandwrightbassfishing.com. It is technology, but we're kind of leaving that off because it makes it a little too long. So lewisandwrightbassfishing.com.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Ooh, that hair is bad. All right, well, you guys saw me talk to Mr. Jim Wright over there. Got some awesome, awesome plastics from him. We're going to be using those in the pretty near future. Slowly but surely selling some jigs. Might go talk to a couple other companies for you guys. If not, we'll do that tomorrow and Sunday. But as of right now, the original rush has stopped and people have started to leave. Everything is dead. Well, 7:23, this place is dead. Nobody's here. People are starting to leave, which is frowned upon, but everybody does it. Most definitely going to be outside of this place in the next update.
Dead and it's not gonna get any busier.
Starting to wander, talk to people, make
arrangements
to talk tomorrow, stuff like that. So, catch you guys when we're in the car, hopefully heading to Skyline again. All right, we're pulling out. It's 8:03. It was actually decent amount of snow on the ground outside. Probably inch or two at least. Today wasn't really, it's a lot slower than a lot of people would have expected. I think tomorrow's the day when the majority of the business happens. You know, there's the most people here. There goes Dean in his stalker van. But we're gonna go get some Skyline because that's how you end every single day in Cincinnati. Isn't that right?
Absolutely.
The Miller Lite and all the little snow. All right, I'm gonna shut up and go to Skyline. All right, well, congrats if you made it to the end of the video. Today, it was just day one. We still have two more days of the Cincinnati Fishing Expo. It's going to be an absolute blast. I cannot wait. So make sure you guys go subscribe and hit the bell so you know when I upload these next couple days while I am in Cincinnati. Go follow me on Instagram at okbassin. I post updates, stuff like that all the time, you know. Alright, well, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, hit the thumbs up. We're going to be talking to more companies tomorrow, and it's going to be a little bit more crowded. I'm your host, Owen. Okay, Bassin. We'll catch you guys on the next one. See ya!